Hello. I like to make today old fashioned sort of traditional recipe for walnut roll. This recipe belongs to my grandmother, and some ingredients a little bit unclear amount of them, but I did work out sort of because when you see, you often just incorporate them and you actually get it right. But we do need a number of ingredients. So what we have is first, preheat oven to 200 degrees Celsius, which is 400 Fahrenheit, and spray a baking tray with cooking spray or oil or butter, whatever you use. It's just a flat type of baking tray. And what we have here, we have 125 gram margarine or butter. Does not matter what you're using. If you will use margarine, there will be have texture of slightly more sort of kind of crumbly sort of, you know. But if butter, they will stay in a place sort of stronger kind of. Well, I using usually butter, but believe me, I did use in past margarines and it tastes as good. So whatever you prefer, do not get worried. 125 gram of butter, which is have to be at room temperature. Now, with this particular ingredient, if you have really soft or almost melted, what will happen? You will use more flour because you need to incorporate it more to make it more manageable to work with dough actually. But if it's a little bit stiffer as this one, you will use less flour. So it doesn't really matter which you have, but that's what aspect is. Now, so we have 125 gram of butter or margarine, and I use about half a cup of just normal average sugar. As you can see, it's already here. You can use slightly less, you can use slightly more. It's only to your taste. If you have a really sweet tooth, you can have it a half a cup or slightly tiny bit more, just a kind of more heaped one. So, but it will be make sweeter taste. So what we do is on this stage, we see simply mixing butter together with the sugar, and as you can see, it's a very simple process. That's all we need. Next step is we have one egg, which is we place right in, and we incorporate it as well. Do not worry if it seems like sort of runny, too hard, and kind of in pieces. It doesn't matter. You just want a little bit to incorporate it, because it's all will mix up later. Just a little bit, just like that. Next is to add half a cup of milk. Now that's done. Which is we mix it as well. See, if you have your butter much softer, almost melted, you will incorporate faster. But as I said to you before, you will use more flour. But if you have it like that, it looks like actually not mixed, but it does mix. So it's okay, just leave it like that. And next is we have heaped half teaspoon of bicarbonate of soda, which is, see, you have a sort of deep type of plate. We have 1 tablespoon of white vinegar. We wanted activated bicarbonate of soda, so we're adding it. As you can see, process it started. We mix it our bicarb with soda until it's all starting activated, and we add it to our mixture as well. So we slightly mix it again. I know it doesn't look too good, but no, that's okay. It's all good. So next step is we add just a tiny bit pinch of salt, just a little bit. Now, comes to flour is we start adding it 1 cup at a time. So after first cup, do not get stirred in, because we, if your butter is was just like mine, to sort of in pieces, you will difficult to incorporate it. As you can see, it's already started. We just have to mix it, and now add another cup. And mix it again. You can see it's already start form into nice dough. Key is mix very well, because we want to break our butter to make sure it becomes smooth consistency. But if you worry about do this process, what you do is, as I said before, just have very, very soft butter, almost melted. You will not be worried, because it's incorporated much, much faster. I like to use a little bit less flour, that's why I do this way. But that's okay, otherwise it'll be fine. Do not get worried, look of it, just mixing all together. So we have 2 cups on this stage. And this is 3rd cup, which is we sprinkle first, because we start see how much of flour we actually using. I would say it's about 3 cups, something like that, on this stage. I would say this would be probably enough. As you can see, it starts forming into a ball. So we sprinkle a little bit of our flour on a working surface. And what we do is we carefully transfer our mixture. And we start knead a little bit. Do not use extreme amount of flour, because less you using it, in particular this recipe, more tender your walnut roll will be. It will be not tough. You don't want it tough, because you want it nice to bite. And for this reason, I do use less flour. So carefully, just a little bit. As you can see, I did not sprinkle too much of flour. From outside, we carefully draw it in. Don't need to be mixed much too. And it's practically done. So what we do is now, how you will know that you mix well, that as you can see, it works very well, and it does not stick practically to your hand. So this is good. Next step is we sprinkle much more flour now. It's difficult to say how much we actually use in flour, because some of it need to basically to sprinkle. Do not get worried about this stitch about flour. This is just from outside. Now, while our dough is resting, next step is to process our walnuts. To process our walnuts, what we have is, we need 125 gram of walnuts. Doesn't matter it's a whole walnut, it's a half, so crumble does not really matter. I usually measure by just simple old-fashioned glass, but that's 125 gram. What we have to do with it, we have to process with about just slightly not full cup of sugar. If you like to have it a bit more sweeter, you can use 1 cup of sugar. If you don't like as sweet, you can use less, like 2/3 of cup of sugar. Now, what you have to do, if you do have a food processor, use a food processor and just process it walnuts together with sugar. If you do not have food processor, you can use one of those old-fashioned mincers. Just simply process all together your walnuts and the sugar and until it's all combined. And what you will get, this sort of mass. So you simply place for easier to use type of hand mincer, just like what I was using, like that. What you do is process one cup of walnuts first, add the sugar, mix it together, and do it once more to make sure it's fully incorporated. As you can see, that's what we will get. But if you have a food processor, great, using it. So basically, that's our walnuts. So next step is to roll our dough to make sure it does not stick. Sprinkle plenty flour underneath, and what we want is we want it roll into kind of a long sort of shape, rectangular. If you see somewhere stick underneath, just place a little bit more flour. Once you roll it into a rectangular shape, as you can see, it just depends how thick you want it. It will bake if it's about a half a centimeter thickness, or less, about 0.4, something like that. But you will get about 30 by about 50, or about 33 by about 54. It just depends how far you spread it. So what we do is next, we place our walnuts on middle of our rectangular shape. You can use a spoon if you like it to do so, or you can use a butter knife. I'm using actually my hands. So what we do is, now we spread our mixture. As you can see, we leave a border about 1 centimeter to make sure when we start rolling, it's a little bit easier. Make sure our walnut mixture don't come out too much. So what we do is here, as you can see, I bring up here a little bit closer. Reason is I done that because I start from here to roll it. So this doesn't matter. But all other borders need to be about 1 centimeter. So nicely spread it. Make sure it's nice and evenly spread everywhere. If you don't like to use walnuts, you can use any other nuts of your choice, or you can even use something like apricot jam or apple jam or any other kind of sort of fillings, because it's all will work with this sort of dough. Now what we do is here, we start slowly rolling. We start from one side, of course, and we roll it nice and carefully, no need to hurry. And we go in. So we roll into have some walnuts, tiny bit here, no waste. Everything has to go in. Now, what we do on this present moment, now key is to basically stick and form our shape, our roll. It's a couple ways. You can a little bit wetten even if you like to do so. I usually don't. So what I do, I carefully pinch sides together just to make sure you not make it any holes anywhere. But if you roll your dough into about half a centimeter, it should be very well. You shouldn't be have any troubles. But you can wetten slightly and stick straight away as well. I usually pinch, that's why I do this way. So what we do is here, we pinch right away through. Make sure it's all nicely done. And we secure everywhere. Once we're happy with everything what we achieve, what we do is here, we slightly press. As you can see, that part, that's where we connected. So that part actually will be our bottom part. So we carefully twist it. And now we straighten up our roll to a nice shape. We just close it everywhere. See, as you can see, it's a plenty flour on top, but it's not really flour which is in the dough. This flour help us to manage actual dough, so it will not stick and makes it much easier for you to work with. Now, here our roll is done, so we just simply a little bit make cleaner and bring up our tray. So we start cutting. I just place a little bit flour for easier to cut. For about, I even don't know how many that would be. It's about 3 centimeter thick type of rolls, and place them on top of our baking sheet. So we carefully place. They will spread, but not that much. So let's continue and finish our roll. So once we cut them, so we cut about 15 walnut rolls, but believe me, I make them about 3 centimeter basically wide. You can make them bigger, so you can make them 12 or 14 or whatever, because it actually does not really hugely matter. Don't make them huge, but for about you can make them actually double size. So this is 3 centimeter wide. You can make them about 5 to 6 even. It just depends. So it makes portion simply bigger. It's so in we work out this will be about 15, just about. You can get 14 or whatever. And so now we place in our preheated oven for about 15 minutes. It's of course depend from your oven how you will know they are baked. They will slightly rise and top will be nice golden color. So once you get this golden color and you can see the rise and puffed sort of, it's they not be hugely rise and puffed, but you can see in the a little bit tiny bit spread, just a little bit. And what you do is take it out and place on a cooling rack. Once they bake, in my oven it took about 15-16 minutes only. As you can see, they did not spread really much. The only molak just come out sort of a tiny bit from the middle. That's all. It's not really much for spread. And that's what's basically how they look like should be. Now, as you can see, the golden color. What you do is next, place them in a cooling rack to cool. Now our walnut rolls are ready, and as you can see, this is just on a cooling rack, and this one I just place on a sort of serving plate. And you can sprinkle with just a powdered icing sugar or the vanilla sugar as well, great too. This kind of walnut rolls excellent for tea or coffee, and it's great because it has a great amount of walnuts in it, so you just can intake of basically omega-3 a lot of it. what I want to say is everything will be in the description box, but I like to add it that, as I said before, if your butter or margarine or whatever you use is very, very soft, you probably will need a tiny bit more flour. But what you do is just add, just like I did, does not matter, or it's at room temperature or really, really soft, adding it one cup by one, add one cup, and incorporate it, mix it together, then add another one until you see that it's become nice soft dough. It will not stick to your hands, so it's easy can be rolled, so that's how you will know you add enough flour. But probably aim it for about 2.5-3 cups in the average. But I will put everything in the description box, and believe me, do try. It's a great recipe. Thank you very much for your time with me today. I hope you do like it. Until next time, goodbye.